There was a media frenzy on Thursday outside a Beirut house, believed to be the home of ousted Nissan boss Carlos Ghosn, now the subject of an Interpol arrest warrant. It's thought a car seen leaving and then returning to the property was carrying his wife. A man also entered, telling reporters he was a doctor and there for Ghosn's wife. There was no sign, though, of the man the media were hoping to catch a glimpse of. Former auto executive Carlos Ghosn has become an international fugitive after he revealed on Tuesday that he'd fled to Lebanon. The 65-year-old was escaping Japan's justice system, which he described as rigged. Ghosn was first arrested in Tokyo in November 2018. He faces four charges for alleged financial crimes, including hiding income and enriching himself through payments to car dealerships in the Middle East, charges which he denies. Sources close to him say a delay to a trial until April next year and a strict ban on communicating with his wife were behind his decision to flee. It's understood he used a private security company to help him escape Japan on a private jet. Flight tracking data suggests Ghosn used two different planes, flying to Lebanon via Istanbul. On Thursday, Turkish police detained seven people, including four pilots, as part of an investigation into Ghosn's passage through the country. Japanese public broadcaster NHK said authorities there had allowed Ghosn to carry a spare French passport in a locked case while out on bail. It potentially shed some light on how he managed to escape, with other passports believed to be in possession of Japanese lawyers. Ghosn, who holds French, Lebanese and Brazilian citizenship, has deep ties to Lebanon, the country of his childhood. A senior Lebanese security official said it wasn't clear if Ghosn would be summoned for questioning over the Interpol arrest warrant, but said Lebanon doesn't extradite its citizens to foreign states.